spinal cord problem is people and the people over the age of 55. Irregular wear and tear on the bones and cartilage of the neck. Spurs on the spinal bones or the ligaments and the disc problems. These are all the features of the cervical spondylosis. So this is a normal spine. Second, third, fourth, fifth, seventh, etc. It's a normal spine. So typical cervical spondylosis. Spur formation. Narrowing of the disc. It's a typical cervical spondylosis. Excellent. So this, the primary risk factor is aging. Aging is one of the most important risk factor. However, previous injury to the neck can also cause a person to be more susceptible to the disorder, and it is very common in IT professionals. Nowadays, some of the doctors are also always sitting in front of the laptop. So nowadays, the cervical collapse are not at all advisable because that will create a feeling of a disease in an individual. That's why we are putting on exercise rather than physiotherapy rather than cervical collapse. The symptoms may be due to spinal cord compression, spine or spinal nerve root compression, and unsteady jerky walk, loss of flexibility in the neck are the first indication. Loss of flexibility in the neck are the first indication that the spinal cord is compressed. Then with the decreased sensation of the both of the hands and feet is also present. Decreased sensation in the hands and feet. And if the compression is centered around the spinal cord roots, there is usually extreme neck pain that relates to the head, arms and shoulders. If there is any spinal root compression, arms and muscles may weaken and waste away, causing the arms go to limp. There may be wasting of muscles. So it is better to do surgery. Sorry, the exercise. There are a lot of exercises are there for the cervical spondylosis along with our remedy. I think we have no time to demonstrate the exercise. No, no problem. Okay. So levels of stress. Sometimes you may also have stress. You pick up a hitchhiker. Hitchhiker means? Yeah, lift. A beautiful young girl, suddenly she faints inside your car and you take her to the hospital. Now that is stressful. But at the hospital they say that she is pregnant and congratulate you that you are going to be a father. You say that you are not the father. But the girl said you are the father. This is getting very stressful. So, and probably have it since birth. And probably have it since birth. You are extremely stressed but relieved. Stressful, very stressful, extremely stressed but relieved. But on your way home, you are thinking about your three kids. So, that will be the real. Okay. Now, welcome back. Another interesting case of the cervical spondylosis. Another interesting case. Male of 50 years, pain in the neck with the stiffness, he can't turn to the left. Otherwise, by jaw, moving and yawning. Even in yawning, remember, it's very severe pain. Even in yawning. 6 months because of this severe pain. Concomitant numbness in the palms, weakness of the hands, extension, that's pain extended to the shoulder, to the chest, and also to the dorsal region. And the rheumatoid totality, that's a mild contraction intolerant of. That's the main rubric. We have three rubrics, mild contraction disposition to contrary and contradiction intolerance. That rubrics are great difference and medicines are also greatly different. So neurologist would admit six disease, sleeplessness, noise problem. He can't sleep from noise. Mouth the cracked at the time, external throat is back pain, cervical region moving on. Back stiffness, cervical region. That is location specific selection of rubric. Cervical region. Back pain, cervical region, stiffness, cervical region, then assuming is numbness of hands. But unfortunately, we didn't get best result from the 200th potency, though we rise in the potency with a very high success rate. And some of the important remedies that we required in our IPD and OPD, CBC will rise. The most important remedy for the IT professionals in the cervical spondylosis. For IT professionals, and stenosis with the stiffness and pain in the neck. Then asomica, for the sedentary habit, constipation, alcohol, burning pain, turning difficult. Some concomitants. Turning is very difficult, especially in bed. Can't turn from the bed. That's the main indication of morality of noxomica. Turning difficult, even in bed. Sedentary habit, constipation, alcohol, burning spine. Then lecanemab, torticollis with the severe muscle spasm, numbness. This is stressing the remedy for the torticollis, stiff neck. And this remedy is acting very good in lower potency also, even in the 30th potency also. Then calcaneumab is the most used successful remedy in several cases with the rigidity and stiffness in the morning. With the rigidity and stiffness in the morning, turning difficult and tendency to strain easily. Calvia, especially for the right side of cervical spondylosis. Pain extend down from the right side with numbness. And the lesion is mainly at C5, C7. Rusters, pain from false positioning. The numbness by warm application. Lycopodium, that's a concomitance. That's the pain with the urinary plus GAD. Cervical pain with urinary complaints with GAD complaints. And if it is acute, there are best remedies. There are a lot of other remedies, but we have different remedies with very high success rate in our IPD and OPD. You can experiment this in your private practice and publish the papers in PD rather than success. And there's something about the rubric selection. The rubric selection, especially for the cervical spondylosis, we have to give importance to the site first. If it is on the right side, the best remedies are the Santhomeria and Lycopodium, and one of the most important remedy for the left sided cervical spondylosis, especially if it is associated with hypertension or vertigo, the best remedy is Conium Acrylate. There is only one remedy represented for the left sided cervical spondylosis in our cancer report, that is Conium Acrylate. But it should be associated with the vertigo or giddiness or hypertension, etc. It's a very good remedy. So, first give importance to the site in cervical spondylosis. Then modality. So which is the best remedy for the cervical spondylosis looking up on the aggravation? There is only one remedy, and that remedy is 3 marks in our literature. Looking up in cervical spondylosis, the remedy is graphitis. It's a 3-mark remedy. It's a very good remedy, it's a very high success rate. Then stooping aggravation, coughing, turning, etc. That rubric is available in the back, pain, cervical region, coughing, turning, etc. Then extension. So give most important priority to the side, followed by modality in the cervical spondylosis patients or in the rubric selection, then extension. And associated symptoms of cervical spondylosis. Always remember vertigo, tinnitus, and blurring of vision are the associated symptoms in many of the cervical spondylosis. So vertigo is not only due to this hypertension or something. Majority of the patients with the cervical spondylosis, we should suspect. So vertigo, tinnitus, and blurring of vision are the associated symptoms of the cervical spondylosis. And homeopaths should see opportunity in every difficulty, but not difficulty in every opportunity. The previous research was actually posted for surgery. So the rubric. There is a rubric in our synthesis repertory. And there are 6 spondylosis. There is a rubric. Back ankylosing spondyloarthritis, that's the rubric, followed by ankylosis, fibrous ankylosis. Ankylosing spondylitis. Then osteoarthrosis. Which are the important rubric for the osteoarthritis or osteoarthrosis? It's better to call it osteoarthrosis, and there is no sense of inflammation. It's a misnomer, osteoarthritis, but osteoarthrosis. 3 main rubrics for the osteoarthrosis. Whatever may be the joint, if it is on the knee joint. So how do you work out this side? Graphitis is a very common symptom of osteoarthrosis. We have very good rubric with some important remedies for that. Yeah, very good, very good. Extremities, crackling. You can select the joints also, knee joint, elbow joint, or whatever it may be. Then stiffness, the nature of the pain, especially in osteoarthrosis, the pain move on beginning to continue the motion, amelioration. And there is another rubric, that is spondylitis, inflammation, then pelvis dorsalis, that's a direct rubric. Pelvis dorsalis, tuberculosis of the spine, ankylosing spondyloarthritis, then calcification of the spine. We have to take the rubric as caries of spine, it's a cross reference, calcification of the spine. That's very common in rheumatological disorders, especially in the neurospinal disorders. Then how will work out this carpal tunnel syndrome? Nowadays that's very common, even after surgery, the patient might have pain there. And we have some important properties out there. So it is the best remedy in that case. As an intracerebral remedy also, as carpal tunnel. So those are the two questions. There are 24 remedies are there. And the most important remedy is an endothelial remedy or even a half surgery. The best remedy is better with high potency. If it's surgery, if it's on the right side, why on half water right now? Left side, we are giving the best remedy. So if no other symptoms are pointing to some other remedy, you can select this side also. Set up with Turner syndrome. Then what about the tennis elbow? That is also very common. It's very difficult to manage PRP also. They are giving some purine injection. Now, Turner is also a good remedy. Other than that actually the rubric is located in the two chapters, extremities, injuries, elbow, tennis elbow, this is the rubric. Agaricus, Ambra, Arnica, Prionic, Calcarea, Progress, Doctor, and same patients. And there is another rubric in general chapter also. General is injuries, tennis elbow. So gout, important rubric, extremities, arthritic nodosities, You can manage it with very high success rate, gout, uric acid diabetes. Then psoriatic arthritis, skin eruption, psoriasis, joint affections, phytolanthia is the main gravity. Rheumatic fever, how many work out is rheumatic fever? So that rubric, fever, rheumatic fever. In cancer therapy, we will consider it as fever, inflammation. Then rheumatoid arthritis. The rubric for rheumatoid arthritis? Extremities, pain, joints. There is a subheading. Joints, rheumatic. It's a beautiful rubric. That is useful in our day-to-day practice. Extremities, pain, joints, rheumatic. That's the rubric for rheumatoid arthritis. And try to read this chapter in Murphy's repertoire. In cancer repertoire, everything is in the chapter back and extremities, but in synthesis Murphy's repertoire, there are around four chapters. There is a chapter called back, hip, another chapter neck, and another chapter pelvis. And one more case, and I will wind up by 10:30 sharp, 1 hour, 15 minutes, no problem. So, remember the age of the patient, 36. Shiny, that's the pain in the left side of the body, aggravates lying on the affected side and aggravates in 1 month. Pain in the lower back, and this this case the rubric selection is somewhat different, that's why I am presenting this case. Pain in the lower back extending up to left foot, 3 years. Case is actually admitted in our IPD. Then aggravation is stooping, sitting or standing for a time, lying on left side, that is some amelioration. Pain in the cervical region aggravates in 1 month by suddenly turning. Headache after journey, then passage of anemia, migraine, and the left renal calculi. The investigation, this MR report is very interesting. Age is only 36, remember. Lumbar spine is straightening. Straightening of the lumbar spine. L3, L4, desiccation. Desiccation means? Yeah, destruction, sir. Desiccation. Diffuse bulge with the thickest sac indentation. L4, L5 desiccation. In addition to L3 and L4, L4 and L5 desiccation. Diffuse disc bulge with the thickened sac indentation. Desiccation of the multiple cervical levels also. It is only 36. L3, L4, L5. Then desiccation of multiple cervical levels. Posterior bulge at C4, C5 and C5-6. Disc height reduction also because of the desiccation. Disc height reduction. And treatment undergone allopathy and Ayurveda. Ayurveda is very famous in Kerala. And the rubric, general pain duct, back pain spine, head pain riding in a carriage aggravates, back pain extending to lower limb, back pain cervical region burning. And is there any difference between the selection of the rubrics in this case and previous three cases? Yeah, very good, sir. This is not location specific. Yeah, back pain, general rubric, head pain, then back pain extending to lower limb. Devil's pain left because this patient has lesion at multiple levels. C4, C5, L4, L5, then desiccation, etc. at different levels. That's why we took the rubric as general. General's pain spine, pain left, etc. And the repertoire lessons, like assist, phosphorus, lycopodium brastos, and prescription diagnosis, remember the date is also very important. On 2-4 cycling, the lactase is tenable. We are prescribing high potency. But there is an advanced pathological condition, we have prescribed the hypertensive. And almost all the companies are advised to a great extent and discharge on 13. Admitted on 2nd and discharge on 13. 20 still under our treatment with the symptomatic 100% reduction. But we are trying for some pathological correction also. And this is my IPD, our IPD at the GHMC Calicut. And like this, there are several IPDs are there functioning regularly. And I have to manage nearly 250 to 300 patients daily. So there are a lot of physiotherapy. So these are very good physiotherapy units. This is the largest physiotherapy unit in the government sector. Even allopathic colleges don't have this type of physiotherapy unit. So ours is the largest physiotherapy unit in the government sector. So we are doing treatment for the pain, paralysis, nerve injury, deformities, muscle weakness, stiffness, post-traumatic cases, soft tissue injury, arthritis, osteoarthrosis of the knee, gynecological pain like endometriosis, cervical and lumbar spondylosis, fibromyositis, migraine, frozen shoulder, Bell's palsy, tennis elbow, plantar fasciitis, muscle spasm and cramps. A repaired physiotherapist from Army since long time. So what about the philosophic aspect? We should have everything, we should correlate with our philosophy also. So never apply local heat or oils to relieve the pain. That is really worse for the patient. But effective in stiffness and paralysis. It's very effective in stiffness, paralysis and deformities. That's why we are using the physiotherapy. So that is mentioned in Canada lectures on homeopathic material medical under the remedy, Calmia. So always remember, never apply local heat oils only to relieve the pain. Otherwise we can apply, that is effective in stiffness and paralysis. What is the concept of pancan? Salt application is better to relieve the pain. Salt application, that is very better to relieve the pain. That also relieves the weakness of muscles and nerves, according to Pancan. And also prevent the deformities. That is mentioned in the natural family in his clinical material medical. It's a conventional treatment, I think, salt application. Yeah, very good. This will relieve the pain, to relieve the weakness of muscles and nerves, and also that may prevent the deformities. So what about the concept of anemia? That is mentioned in the opposite number 194A. It is not useful either in acute local disease of recent origin or local affections that have already a long time to rub in or apply externally to the spot an external remedy. So it is better to avoid external application only to relieve the pain, especially in the dynamic diseases. Even though it's a specific homeopathicity, it at the same time administered internally for the acute tropical condition, which have not been caused by an external injury of proportionate virus, but by dynamic or internal cause. Always remember, rheumatoid arthritis, etc., dynamic diseases, not of local injury. So, in that case, it is better to avoid the local application. Internal and external together. What is our opinion of anemia? That is mentioned in the opposite number 197. The simultaneous local application along with the internal employment of the remedy in a disease whose chief symptom is a constant local affection. Osteoarthritis, or rheumatoid arthritis, or tubercular arthritis, a constant symptom is a local affection. But actually, it's a disease of dynamic origin. Internal means a dynamic origin. Has this great disadvantage that by such topical application, the chief symptom or the local affection will usually be annihilated sooner than the internal disease. And a perfect cure, at least it will be difficult and in some cases impossible. So, this is a local affection with a dynamic origin. It is better to avoid the external application because it is very difficult to cure. Then he addressed this reduction mandate, local application, etc., local application, that is mentioned in the opposite number 196. Those so-called local maladies which have been produced a short time previously solely by an external lesion because of an injury. Yes. The whole living organism sympathizes. The treatment of such disease is relegated to surgery, but this is right only in so far as the affected part of your mechanical age. By the reduction of dislocation, by bandage, by the extraction of foreign bodies, etc. So that's the concept of the anemia. And remember, the accessory management or accessory lifestyle measures are not the monopoly of any of the medical system. We can send our patient for dialysis by giving our remedies. We can evaluate the creatinine level. We can use the IV, catheterization, right? Whatever it may be, physiotherapy, whatever it may be. The accessory lifestyle measures are not the monopoly of any of the medical system. So try to incorporate in your practice, which offers fast and better results. And a study conducted at GHMC Calicut on the effectiveness of homeopathy in the management of cervical spondylosis, presenting with the cervical radiculopathy. That's the action for a period of June 2004 to September 2005. Maximum age group affected, that is 31 to 40 years. 7 years bonus is maximum in this age group. Incidence is more in middle class. Assessment was based on the changes in the score noted before and after treatment, usually cervical radiculopathy assessment told. And sulfur and persil was found to be most effective and indicated in majority of the patients in cervical spondylitis for a period of June 2004 to September 2005. And I would like to introduce our website to you, similima.com. This is the largest website, you know, on homeopathic education. From 2003 onwards, that's on that. More than 5,000 PowerPoint presentation to more than 2,500 articles. And this is the largest placement portal in homeopathy also. The largest placement portal in homeopathy. And we have a lot of competitive examination materials from PSC, UPSC, PG, and BENS, and whatever it may be, the competitive examination materials and scope of homeopathy in different countries, along with the converting of PSMOs into their qualification. So just visit our website, and name of the website is similima.com. And our new venture, that is Homeobook, which will be launched on September 1st officially. And maybe the largest database on homeopathy. And it's a very mobile friendly website also. That's nowadays majority of people are using mobiles for browsing. It's a responsive thing with a mobile friendly website that will be available officially. Available now itself, but under testing, available from September 1st onwards. And I would like to conclude. Homeopathy offers effective treatment for rheumatological disorders. Detailed case taking and proper repertorization, that's the selection of the routine. Detailed case taking and proper repertorization is highly essential. Higher potencies are useful both in acute and chronic. Homeopathic remedies, along with the accessory management, offers excellent speedy recovery. And it is better to avoid external application only to relieve the